So following on from our last video where we compared timescales on standard chargers versus fast chargers, today we're going to be looking at the cost. Is it still more cost effective to have battery power over petrol or gas power? Because now we're in 2022, electric prices have gone through the roof. Yes, they're double what they were this time last year. We're now paying on average 40 pence per kilowatt hour, whereas last year this time we were paying 21 pence. How does it boil down to using battery equipment compared to petrol? Well, in this test, we have got two smart meters. Yes, just simple ones you plug in the wall. You can get them on Amazon. You can have a look at what the price is in your area very, very cost effectively. They're about 25 quid each. But we're going to plug them into here, one standard charger, one fast charger, because we want to see if there's also a cost difference between using one of these chargers as well. So as you can see, both these 5 amp hour batteries are both flashing red. That means they're both empty. They're both ready to be charged.
This video is sponsored by Hayes Machinery, a one-stop shop for ATVs, trailers, power tools, garden machinery, and robotic mowers. Check out their website, haysmachinery.co.uk, to view the full range. Cheers!
So we've pre-programmed our smart meters at 40 pence per kilowatt hour, which is roughly the UK average. It will vary in your area, so you can work it out accordingly. Got the little timer on here as well. We've got two 5 amp hour, 280 watt hour batteries on a standard and a fast charger. We're going to plug them in as quickly as we can together, and we're going to put the timer on as well, just so that you can see that there's no jiggery pokery going on. So we're going to start the timer. So I can see it's already started reading what watts it is pulling in through the cable. And as you can see, the fast charger is already pulling in 171 watts on the standard charger. And it's got a timer on the top here as well. So that one's been going for 26 seconds, that one's been going for 23 seconds. And I've got the clock down here as well. So hopefully all together, they'll tie in nicely because you've got the green light flashing here, green light flashing here, and an increment digital monitor up here as well. Digital? I don't know, LED, there we go. 5 minute mark, yes, we are at the 5 minute mark, and so far, the standard charger hasn't actually even registered as a penny yet. At 40 pence per kilowatt hour, that has not registered. And that one there is at 1 pence on the fast charger, but obviously it has charged more, so there's the second increment of that battery is flashing. We're still only the first increment on this one is flashing. Oh, very interesting, very interesting. Right, guys, we're at the 30 minute mark. Oh yes, where are we? This one is nearly charged. We're expecting about 40 minutes like it was in the last test. And this one is just flashing between, well, onto nearly the 40% mark there. So it's coming along. Costing so far only 9 pence and it's nearly charged. So look, how it's so cost effective to charge a battery. I thought it was going to be loads more than that, so I'm really amazed. So I'm now going to hand you over to my brother to explain what a kilowatt hour is. Yes, what this is all measured in. What is a kilowatt hour, Norman?
Hello, fellow farmers. I'm Norman, and today you're wondering what KHW means. What's a kilowatt hour? It's 1,000 watts, and that's how they measure your electricity to charge you, so they can take your money and milk your money out of you to pay for your electric. Well, how does a kilowatt hour work? A lot of people think it's how many watts you use in an hour, but it's actually not. It's what it is how long it takes the appliance to use 1,000 watts. So if you take a light bulb, you know, one of these things with that on the bottom and some sparky things coming out the top, that is a 100-watt light bulb, it'll take 10 hours to use 1,000 watts. But if you've got a 2,000-watt appliance, like a kettle, you know, for boiling your water, then that's only going to take half an hour. It's actually quite interesting.
Interesting thing you can hear now is that this battery is nearly full. But when I commented on this at 30 minutes in, so 4.5 minutes ago, that this one's at like 500 watts. So it's getting to the top end of the battery capacity. So the charger is allowing the battery to slow down its charge. So the top end of the battery is charged a lot slower than what it is of when it is in the middle peak of its battery. So it's really interesting that it's dropping the draw as it's getting fuller. So there we are, battery fans. Yes, that is now full. That battery is full and it has cost 11 pence.
which I believe in dollars is like 14 cents. It costs 11 pence to charge that battery. As you saw, that the draw, the wattage draw that is coming through the smart meter has been dropping for the last like 5 minutes. It was up at like 500 and has really just dropped down gradually and slowly and slowly and slowly. And it has now dropped a lot lower than what the draw is on the standard charger. The standard charger has been around the 178, 179 mark now the whole time it's been charging. What we're going to do now, just see how hot these batteries are in the chargers. Do it now on the little vent. That is 20 degrees. And on the standard charger, it is also 20 degrees. So very similar temperatures on both batteries. As you can see, obviously the fast charger charges it quicker and uses 11 pence. There we are, guys, right just before the 100 minute mark, that battery has fully charged. But we're at 12 pence on this one and 11 pence on this one. By the time this one's finished dropping and completely finished its cycle, I reckon that'll be at 12 pence as well. Which makes sense, you know, it's 2 5 amp hour batteries with 280 watt hours of goodness inside them. But well, that one has now gone to zero. The charger has shut down. So we'll take both out, both out, both fully charged. So there we are. Yeah, the fast charger has cost 12 pence and took 51 minutes. And the standard charger cost 11 pence and took an hour and 41. It's amazing, you know, that one's going for longer, but it doesn't cost as much. Who knew? 12 pence to charge a battery in 2022. What can you buy for 12 pence? You can't even buy a Freddo anymore, but you can charge a battery. Doesn't really matter which charger you buy, whether it's fast or standard, for cost-wise. It's got me thinking, 12 pence worth of power in there, right? Okay. We've got another video coming up with an Ego strimmer and a petrol strimmer, and we're gonna put 12 pence worth of fuel, yeah, at 2022 prices, in a strimmer and put it up against an Ego strimmer and see which one goes the furthest. Oh yes, that is an experiment that you need to subscribe to our channel for so you don't miss it. So please like, share, subscribe, and then you get to see me and my mates, Norman, all over again. We'll see you next time. Cheerio.